Hello and good evening, sixth form. I know you see Alia up on the screen right now, but it is actually Areeba speaking. And unfortunately for you all, I am your default host for the evening, after Mr. Smith, of course. The reason behind that is simply because no one can come help me right now. Well, to start off the night, I'm going to this is completely not biased, by the way. Start off with my amazing best friend, Alia Kazmi, who has worked very hard for this SG position since year 9 and has grown into a powerful young woman who still manages to have fun and delegate tasks amazingly well.
Hi, when I was asked to give this little speech on what I achieved during the MUN school year, I was scared. Mainly because I felt like I didn't achieve enough and I let people down. And then I looked at the facts and I realized that we did achieve a lot. We were able to have 160 delegates this year, which was the biggest amount of delegates that we ever had in the entire of MUN. With our 20 trainers and our 6 executives, we were able to split them up, teach them MUN procedures, and even some of our delegates were able to go to HMC Dubai and participate in the very highly coveted conference and come back with awards and honorable mentions. We were able to have our first UNODC commission, and it was quite a success. And those little achievements that may not seem as monumental did a lot for the program. One of our executives, Robert, was able to program an entire MUN-based program, which was able to send out resolutions and have an email bot to send position papers directly to trainers themselves rather than having to go through the entire mess of emailing. And all of this contributions we had was a collective effort, and that's why I would like to thank my MUN trainers, my MUN executives, my MUN supervisors for always supporting me and allowing me to make decisions and trusting me with that honor. I also would like to thank my classmates for basically opening me up more and getting me out of my little bubble. I've made connections with people that I never thought I would, and I'd like to thank them for that. So I hope you guys are all staying safe and you follow the rules of the quarantine, and I just want to say thank you to all of you, and I hope I will see you guys soon. Thank you.
Next up, we have Rahul, our local fish dog, and the CEO of HeHeHe during a student voice speech in year 12. Hashtag never forget. But a good man nevertheless, presenting Rahul's speech. Also, I forgot to add, he's peer-to-peer coordinator for this year. Or, well, was.
Hi everyone, it's Rahul, your peer-to-peer coordinator this year, and here's a short message for you. So, obviously this is a really hard time for every single one of us. Staying home, yeah, it's cool and all, but it gets boring pretty quick. There have been perks to all of this, you know, no exams. I mean, hey, who's gonna complain about no exams, right? But at the same time, not being able to interact with your friends, it's a pretty difficult thing, because staying alone in isolation can take a mental toll on you. So I hope it's my friend Duck over here, right? I hope every single one of you have something to keep you distracted. Literally all I do is just work out and play video games. I play video games a bit too much, I should probably cut down on that, you know? But still, at least I work out, so you know what, that's good enough, right? Also to all the tutors for part of the peer-to-peer program, I just want to say thank you for everything you've done. The more tutors I had, the more opportunities I got, you know, for me to expand my arsenal. So I just want to say I'm really grateful for that. It's a shame things had to end so soon, because I did have a few plans to sort I wanted to carry out, especially it's more geared towards the year 9s, 8s and 7s, but because of this whole pandemic and this unexpected issues and all that, I wasn't able to carry out that. So I'm really sorry if you never had a chance to tutor anyone, and hopefully my successor, I'm not going to tell you who it is just yet, you'll figure it out soon enough, hopefully he or she will be able to fill the gaps that I was never able to fill. And And this doesn't apply just to all the tutors. This also applies to every single student. Thank you for everything you've done. Thank you for staying strong during this really, really, really hard time. You know, and please stay home, stay safe, and just listen to your parents. All right, goodbye. Have fun. Also, I'm not sure if you're going to see this, but just here's a quick side note as well. Because of quarantine, many people found a thing to do, like a hobby or whatever, right? Whatever it may be. It may be art, it may be working out even, it may be maybe you found your passion in your subject, you know, one of those things, right? But you need to keep in mind that when you start something, you're obviously not going to see progress really quickly, right? Not necessarily. You have to do it over time to actually see the results, right? And that's the thing I want to say. Because of that, people tend to lose interest in whatever they're interested in at that point in time, right? So people often overestimate what you can do in a day, but they underestimate what they can do in a year, you know? So like, just keep at it, don't quit, and you'll see your results soon enough. Yeah, that's it.
Carol is the best writer in our sixth form community, and it comes of no shock to see that she is the head of the print, and I am so proud to work alongside her as her deputy editor, and so proud to work alongside someone who is kind and sweet and makes the funniest sarcastic comments ever. Here's her speech.
Hi everyone, this is Carol, and I've had the honor of being this year's editor of the print. Now, when we think of the print, the first thing that may come to mind would be how many issues we've published or how many writers we had. And while I will admit we've been successful in those two respects, seeing as we've welcomed aboard a few primary writers whose work you can find on our website, nestheprint.com, and we have published 9 issues, which was difficult considering the circumstances, to say the least. I think the print's about a lot more. I think it's about the development of our writers and editors alike as individuals, which you can really, really see through the articles' writing styles and subject matter. But I feel you can sense that a lot more in our actual meetings. They've all shown maturity and creativity, and it was inspiring to see them carry that level of enthusiasm into a room and just get ready to write. So I'm thankful for that. Now, on that note, I'd like to thank one of our biggest team players, Reem, who is also an editor. Now the thing about Reem is she is a team player. That's just who she is, and she's just been so responsible and honest and trustworthy and reliable, and she's been a joy to have on board. So thank you, Reem, for being who you are and for your contributions. On that note, thank you to everyone, our writers, editors, and readers, for your contributions and for all of your support. You've made this year a joy. Stay safe and enjoy your holiday.
Next up, we have Ferris, our co-head of the TRDP program, a program I am deeply connected to since year 10, and an imposter who has constantly invaded year 13's cube. But we don't say anything because he is one of the greatest artists in sixth form, and we always looked forward to seeing his drawings on the common room board. Presenting Ferris.
Hello, how's it going? If you don't already know who I am, my name's Ferris, and I was in year 12, and this year I served as co-head of the TRDP, and I suppose this message is just to sort of say, I hope you're all doing well, I suppose, but also to recap on what we've done this year. And first of all, I'd like to say I'm quite proud to have had this role. It's an experience. It's always motivating to do something new with your life, because if you're not moving, then you're not living. That's how I feel. And, you know, we definitely were moving a lot in the program. We were doing a lot of different activities. One of our biggest achievements, definitely continuing on from last year, is the CAP talks, which we had a lot of our most confident docents do, and they did amazingly. So that's pretty good. We started reforming a lot of sections of the program, which we felt were good, but they could be a lot better. And that's what we're always trying to do at the DOSIP program, what I hope that they'll continue to do as me and Amishi start to sort of leave the program and move on. You know, to just keep pushing towards our very, very best selves. And I think that's important not only in the program, but in all of our lives. So with that, I hope that you all are sort of spending your time as constructively as you can. And yeah, before you know it, this will all be over and your life will go back to normal. So anyways, that's just a little message from me. So yeah, happy quarantine, everybody.
And this is Amishi, also the chair of the TRDP program. The year 12's designated astrologer and Starbucks representative. Of course, after Mia, which is why I said the year 12 Starbucks representative, presenting Amishi.
Hello everyone, my name is Amishi Singh, co-head of the TRDP. As Faris mentioned earlier, there were definitely a lot of moments that deserve to be talked about and recognized within the TRDP this year, despite the short end to it. However, today I will be announcing the MVP for the TRDP. It was not an easy choice because there were 16 docents, all of whom incredibly talented and dedicated. Faris and I did manage to narrow it down to one docent, Abdulrahman Atona, who always went above and beyond to fulfill all his duties as a docent. Congratulations. I would also take this moment to be grateful for the opportunity I was given this year to lead an incredible group of docents, to lead an incredible program, and just to be a part of something that was more than just being a student at NES, for being part of the leadership team. I really enjoyed it, and I hope that most, if not all, docents decide to continue with the TRDP in the next academic year. Thank you.
So many of you are already going to know Hafiz. He's a man of many talents, the CEO of EcoTune, a chem intern, also part of the podcast earlier on in the year, and a really fun guy to be around in general. This is Hafiz's speech.
Hello everyone, I hope you're all staying safe at home. Just a quick word from the environmental area. I would like to thank every single one of you for contributing to the recyclables and the recycling area in EcoTune. We have collectively recycled 1,959 bags of recyclables. This is an unprecedented amount. This is something I would have never imagined we could have done. So thank you all so much for it. A special thank you goes out to as well Mrs. Armstrong for helping lead this area, and also all the children that are part are of the club. So thank you all for that. I would like to also give a special mention to Omar Aldeeb and Yusuf Ahmed for achieving the blue card, which means they've single-handedly recycled 200 bags of recyclables. This is impressive, so congratulations to you guys on that. And finally, I would like to award the MVP award to Arpita for her marvelous artwork and the efforts that she's put into EcoTune this year to make it the success that it was. Although it was cut short. So thank you all for that. And most importantly, stay safe and enjoy your summer holiday.
And this is Aisha, the woman behind all of our greatest memories in sixth form. From the Think Pink dinner at the beginning of the year, to those simple events happening every single week, and every single charity fundraiser that has helped our community in many ways. Presenting Aisha.
My name is Aisha and I am the chairman of the social committee for the years 2019 to 2020. If you don't know what the social committee are, we're a group of people who plan, organize, and run the fundraising events held by the school throughout the year. And these events included Think Pink Dinner, Blue Day, talent show, numerous coffee mornings, as well as the selling of badges and ribbons during Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And I'm proud to say that we raised around 1,500 KD during these events. And thank you to everyone who came. And thank you to my team. I honestly couldn't have picked a group of better people. They were so helpful and willing to do any task I would ask them without hesitation. So thank you guys. You honestly made this year run so smoothly. So that's why it's so hard to pick an MVP, because I genuinely wish I could give it to all of them because they all did amazing. But if I have to pick one, someone who stood out a lot was Natalie, I would say, because she had some great creative ideas, not only for events, but also for our board, which is hanging up in the common room, probably wondering where we've all been for the past few months. But yeah, Natalie, thank you. You always were willing to stand up and take charge if I wasn't there. For example, in the talent show when I was late because I had a game beforehand, you really took charge and made the night a great one. And you always completed tasks to perfection, and thank you for that. Thank you. You would never complain when I would give you a task. But thank you to my team. I'm genuinely gonna miss you guys so much. You made this year amazing, and I hope you all made some memories during events, because I know I did. And I really hope a lot of you will continue on to be part of the social committee next year, and I can't wait to see pictures of the beautiful events that you guys make, and you're gonna make me proud. Okay, I'm gonna miss you guys so much, and thank you for everything.
Our next speaker puts the air in error. Excuse my really cringy joke, but introducing Karem, our local Dogwood Diaries influencer, the man who likes to play devil's advocate just because he's bored, our deputy head boy, Karem.
Good morrow, NES. I myself hope that you are all doing well, and you and your families are trying to make do, I suppose. The situation we're in is quite unique. It's hopefully a once in a century occasion, but it has meant that I get to go to university without sitting my A levels. So I guess I've benefited to some extent, but it's a good time to start considering maybe picking up a musical instrument, a hobby, learning a language on Duolingo, possibly looking at computer programming, and just trying to keep busy with something. Could be art. I, for one, am enjoying my time walking Merlin over here. We're about to go on the long walk of the day. But I know that it can get a bit tough. It's just, we all have to hang in there. There is literally nothing we can do, so try to, I suppose, make the most of it. This year, I was lucky enough to be an exec in the MUN team and deputy head boy, so I got a chance to work with quite a lot of people, be it prefects or MUN trainers, MUN, other MUN execs. But overall, I was really quite happy with the way that everything ran this year. Of course, we didn't get to get the conference due to Corona and other reasons, so there are a lot of things that we've all missed out on. The farewell dinner, black and white, the barbecue. But at the end of the day, it's an experience to put in the books. It's just 1 year, hopefully. So just hang in there, hang tight. Thank you all for a great year, and I wish you all the best. Deputy head boy, out.
This is Mia, a wonderful woman, a part of my literature class that is very dear to my heart, and the woman who made sure that all the prefects were doing their job and perfectly felt welcome, and our year 13 Starbucks representative, Mia.
Hello, Sixth Form. I'm Mia, and I've been your deputy head girl for the past academic year. I'd like to start by saying I hope you and your families are safe and well, and you've been using this time wisely to relax and reflect on the past year. This school year, Karem and I have been given the absolute privilege of creating a team of 30 prefects, all of which have been so amazing, so hardworking. So thank you so much to all of you for all of your efforts. They really do not go unnoticed. Whether it was walking around the corridors on your duties, helping staff around the school, or giving parents tours, you really have demonstrated what it means to be a prefect alongside being a Model NES student. During the school year, there have been many parents' evenings, all of which were coordinated, set up, and run by the prefects. And honestly, just to step back and watch them take on this responsibility and grow into these strong, confident individuals was lovely to watch. And how helpful they were and kind they were to the staff and parents of the school was so amazing. So you should all be extremely proud of yourselves for these evenings, that they ran so smoothly due to your help. Alongside this, there was a spring bazaar in which the prefect's continuous enthusiasm and positivity during selling the tickets enabled more tickets than ever to be sold, raising so much money for those who really need it. It was lovely, and I cannot thank you guys enough for giving up your time and your break times to go and sell those tickets. It was amazing to watch. And when thinking about this year's prefect team, I think about all the strong and confident individuals there are. But two of them have stood out, and this is for their continuous efforts within the team and helping us and listening and being as respectful as possible. They truly made criminalized jobs a lot easier. So we'd like to extend our gratitude towards Anime and Sheikh, who are this year's MVPs. You truly have been so amazing, and once again, we are so thankful for your efforts. And I would like to end this just by saying thank you to all 30 of you, and to Karem for being such an amazing person to work next to and work alongside. It has truly been such a journey, such a ride, and I am so thankful for everything you have all contributed to this year. You've truly made my last year at NES so memorable, and that's all down to you guys. So thank you so much. I hope you stay safe, and I wish you all the best of luck on your future endeavors, and thank you for the best year at NES.
Neshikit's always been so involved in the community, from helping out his fellow peers in really difficult math questions, to just participating in those random activities and random things that we would always get up to in the common room. This is our head boy, Neshikit.
Hi everyone, so this is probably the last time I'll be speaking to you, and although I could talk to you a great deal about my head boy experiences, what we have done, or life lessons in general, I really don't want to talk about that today. Today, I just want to share a very personal and a somewhat silly moment with you, right? So this was back on a busy October day. Rana and I were making a poster for the blackboard, and for some reason, I just found that it was really amusing to dash across the playground with the poster like held like this, like rubber banded on my shoulder, and shout, "This is Sparta!" It was just incredibly fun. Right, what's the great point in this? There's no great point, except that sometimes it's just important to have your inner child step back and enjoy the small things around you, man. That can be really refreshing at times, really. And on that note, I would like to show you my child. This is the first time I'm trying this, so don't judge, okay? Why don't you say so? Didn't even notice. No punches
that to roll with. You got to keep me focused. You wanna... She is a woman that's always been greatly involved in the community of NES, from making sure that a random year 7 is doing completely okay on the playground, to making sure that a fellow peer is having a good day. Rana's always been there for everyone and always made sure that they're okay, and has always carried her duties flawlessly, and has always, always managed to hype up the common room environment and make comments fun for everyone, even on a dull day. Presenting our head girl, Rana Kiswani.
Hi guys, I hope you're all well, staying safe, and coping in the middle of this lockdown. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Rana Kiswani. I was your head girl for the year 2019 and 2020, or well, what we had of it. I just wanted to give a quick thank you and recap how this year went for Neshikit and I, and just say our final goodbyes within our position. So I would just like to thank literally everyone at NES. It's not even a joke. Senior management, Miss Rawa, Mr. Smith, Miss Robotham, all the staff, even the students. You know what? The students, you, especially lower school, you made my time at NES so exhilarating, so wonderful. You are all so filled with energy and so bright and filled with so much potential. And I can't wait to come back and visit and see some of you really growing into your personalities and as people, as academics, as people in MUN. It is so exciting to see. And of course, Neshikit and the leadership team, who have made this year run so smoothly. I could not be more thankful to have such a brilliant team. team, and such supportive teachers constantly pushing us through the way, even if it was just with a quick good morning in the hallway, or being my wonderful literature, history, and business teachers who would constantly make the time to make us laugh and have a good time and really educate us. The NES experience is beyond unique, and I am so glad to have been a part of it. And not only was it a brilliant experience, but a lifelong experience I will take with me wherever I go, especially when I go to university. So thank you for that. I cannot thank you enough. And I'd like to say that although our year got cut short, I'm very proud of the work Nachiket and I have done and the work that the Student Voice have done. A quick shout out to them and all of their hard work. Thank you so much, and as sad as I am to have the year end like this, I bid you all adieu and I wish you all the best of luck. Thank you and stay safe.